You're tuned to WCW-TV Channel 25, What Chicago Watches.
The following program is a production of ETC, Ethnic Television Chicago.
Try to do our best, fulfill all your requests, make you feel like our special guest. One more thing that we all want you to know, hope you'll enjoy the show. So sincerely from our hearts, it's music from the stars.
Well, a very pleasant afternoon to you, and welcome to this month's edition of the Poker Video Spotlight. I'm very honored and pleased to have with me in the studio. It's a change to be back in the studio. We've been out all over the city of Chicago and out of town with these shows, but we are back here in Chicago, and we have with us the Sunshine Girl from WPNA, Emilie Richards. Good afternoon, Emilie.
Nice to be here again.
Yeah, you've been like a regular almost here on Poker Videos.
It's been fun. I really enjoy it.
Well, that's good. This afternoon, though, we're going to get a little serious and talk about your involvement in the poker field as well as your radio show and what your outlook on the poker field is in the coming years. Let's start from the beginning. Let's start out with how you first got involved in the poker field.
Well, I'll tell you, Keith, ever since I've been a little girl, I wanted to be an actress, a movie star, which never materialized. But way back in 1951, 52, I had a chance to be on the radio with John Yaminski. Mm-hmm. I was probably way before your time.
I remember hearing him.
You probably heard the name.
Right, exactly.
But I knew John very well. And I was doing commercials for him on his show for a short period, like a year. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, I was married, I had children, and I forgot about it. And now, when Polish National Alliance bought WPNA radio station, I was offered the opportunity, and I grasped it. And I love it. I really enjoy it. I'm finishing my fourth year. I'll be starting the fifth year on May 2nd. And I hope...
Well, you started your fifth year, because this is May, we're already in May. This is the second week of May.
That's right.
So
So I'm in my fifth year now, and I hope I have at least 50 more to go.
You started out with, you were a team with Lucy Bonteschetti when you first started.
Yes, we had an hour show at that time, and I asked her to join me on the Sunshine Polka Show. We were on together for 2 years, and... We just decided that I had a different outlook on what I wanted to present on the radio than what she wanted to present on the radio. Mm-hmm. So we decided to split the hour. Mm-hmm. And I've got the first half hour and Lucy has the second half hour. And it's working out very well.
Mm-hmm. When you say in 1950s when you first started on the radio, were you active in the poker field as much as you are now?
No, I wasn't at that time. I was married to a man who was Scotch-Irish, who had absolutely no interest in the polkas. And I had two little babies, so polkas was the last thing I wanted to think about. But I've always been involved in the polka aspect, not in the actual dancing or singing or the records. I've always played the records. I've got records from way back when. And that was always my secret love.
Maybe, you know, you can give a little insight. You're not a teenager. You're not in your 20s. You're not in your 30s.
I'm a senior citizen.
Okay. You said it. I didn't. I was trying to be trying to elude the subject. Okay. So for a lady of your age to start out 5 years ago and to take this big undertaking of producing her own poker show took a lot of fortitude and a lot of thoughtfulness.
It really didn't, because this was my secret ambition for years. So it was just something that's been inside all these years. It just came out naturally.
But you know as well as I do that it's not easy like everybody thinks, and everybody thinks they make millions of dollars
doing this, right?
I mean, it's hustling
a struggle.
It's a struggle.
And I think it's even more difficult for an older woman than it is for a young man, because you've got to go out into the field and try to get the sponsors. And unless you're a super salesman, it's very difficult.
Well, this is what I was getting at. You undoubtedly have overcome that fear, and because you're certainly not a flash in the pan, you are successful. You've been on for 5 years now.
Yes, and thank God it hasn't been a total loss.
How much longer do you see yourself continuing?
As long as the good Lord gives me my good health, I will keep on.
What's the most pleasure you get out of doing the radio program? What one thing maybe is really gives you the most gratification?
The most satisfaction is to promote the polka music, the recording stars, the albums, and let the whole world know about polkas.
Okay. You're also heavily involved with an organization in the Chicagoland area. I think you hold an office. I'm not positive. In the Senior Polka Association.
I am so active in the polka field. I belong to all of the polka associations. I'm a member of the International Polka Association, which you are a director,
sure.
I understand.
Yeah.
I'm a director in the United Polka Association, and I'm the secretary in the Senior Polka Association North Chapter. So I'm quite involved, and it does take a lot of time, which I'm just about ready to give up and devote more time to my radio show.
Tell us a little bit about your outlook on the polka field. You've said it's been your secret love for a number of years.
Yes,
you've been exposed to it. You've been around it for a number of years. Let's talk about the days back in the 50s and the 60s. Can you compare them to the 90s today?
Well, of course. There's no comparison.
In what respect there's no comparison?
Way back in the 50s, the polkas was something that was practiced by the older Polish generation, not the young Americans. And today, I'm happy to say that a lot of the youngsters are getting into it. And I give them a lot of credit, because to begin with, to dance the polka, it's a little tricky to get that tempo, you know. And a lot of the youngsters are getting into it. And a lot of our weekends that we have out of town, the polka festivals, there's a lot of young people in it. But it isn't progressing as rapidly as I would like to see it progress.
Well, what do you mean when you say that, progressing as rapidly? You mean for national exposure? Or?
That's right, for national and for acceptance. For acceptance by the outside world, you know. We're still considered an ethnic group, which of course we are, but I would like to see it more on an equal basis with the hard rock, rock and roll, and country western, and it really isn't yet.
Well, what can we do to get it to that level?
I wish I knew.
You don't have any idea at all?
I knew. I really don't. I think maybe it's up to the parents to get their youngsters more involved in it, and to really explain to them what it means, you know, to the background of the Polish people. And this isn't being done.
I've got to relay a real quick off the subject, or kind of like on the subject, I got to relay a funny story that I heard last week. You know Jerry Van Trova?
Yes, very well.
His very young son, which is like maybe 1.5 or 2 years old, was in the hospital. And he was on the southwest side, and I guess there were nurses were tending to him, and he couldn't be there all the time. And the kid was screaming for polka music.
Yeah.
So the black nurse couldn't understand what he was asking for. She said, when Jerry came to the hospital, he said, "Your son is asking for polka or polka?" She says, "Oh, he wants polka tape." So he put in a polka tape, and the kid was as quiet as a mouse, really loved it, you know.
Well,
so this is the type of thing that you need to maybe instill.
That's right.
Start them from a year and a half.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah.
Emily, what's one of your favorite bands that you really like?
Eddie Blazonczyk and the Versatones are my favorites.
Okay. Well, we're going to show one of their videos right now that we produced here on the ETC network. It's called the Chicagoland Polka, and we did this on Lake Michigan. So So right now we're going to take a break. Let's show that. Eddie Bozoinchik and the Versatones.
Oh, that'll be nice. Good, good.
Countryside, I've been both here and there. I've seen the gals in other towns, there's none that can compare. North and south and east to west, there's just one place for me. It's known as the Windy City, it's the place to be. Oh, I wish I was back in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight. Oh, I miss those gals in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight. I should have never left Chicago as a little boy. I should have stayed right at home back in Illinois. Oh, I wish I was back in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight. This land of ours, I've really moved around. From coast to coast, I've traveled and roamed its cities and small towns. With my band, I've toured this land, for you we're gonna play a song about my favorite place in the good old USA. Oh, I wish I was back in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight. Oh, I miss those gals in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight. I should have never left Chicago as a little boy. I should have stayed right at home back in Illinois. Oh, I wish I was back in Chicago town, Chicago town tonight.
Hello, this is Sig Sakowitz. I've been visiting Poland since 1958. This is my 11th tour, August 7th through the 20th. After arriving in Warsaw, we'll check into the Victoria Hotel, then on to Lublin, where we'll visit our friends at the Catholic University and lunch with the hierarchy. Then on to the Tatras in Zakopan, plus a full day in Czechoslovakia. In Krakow, you'll shop till you drop at the Cloth Hall, Sukhenyets, visit the Wieliczka, the world-famous salt mine, dine at internationally known Wierzyny. Then on to Częstochowa, where Mayor Ted Wrona will escort us to Jasna Góra. There's more, including Wadowice, Pope's hometown, raft rides, a buggy ride, and more. For information and brochure, call Gina, Helen, or Pauline at 312-774-6206.
Lot Polish Airlines, now more than ever, the recognized leader in travel to Poland.
We're back, and we're joined this month by Emilie Richards from radio station WPNA of the Sunshine Polka Show. Emilie, we talked a little bit about your involvement in the polka field currently, and as well as we showed a video by Eddie Bozoinchik, who you say is one of your favorite orchestras. I understand that you just got back not too recently from touring Las Vegas with a group of listeners.
Yes, I had a group of 25 senior citizens, and everybody had a good time. We enjoyed it.
Are you branching on to the travel agency business?
Not really, but it seems like I'm not going to have any other choice because everybody wants to go back.
Uh-huh. Well, that's good. That's good. Let's talk a little bit about some of the women that have been involved in the polka field. A few come to mind. Lucy.
Ann Pshoa.
Ann Pshoa. also Jenny O, Antoinette Bozoinchik, some of those, Emily Pinter, there hasn't really been a lot of women involved in the polka field. Any particular reason why you think that is?
I really don't know. Maybe the love wasn't as strong as it should have been, the love for the polka field.
Can you maybe expound on that a little bit?
Well, you've got to live polkas morning, noon, and night. You eat them, you sleep them. This is part of your life. Mm-hmm. And unless you feel that way, you're not going to give it all. It's the same as falling in love. Mm-hmm. You either love all the way or you don't love.
Right.
And that's the same way with the polka field. You either have to love it all the way or forget it.
Was it hard for you to get started in the polka field?
No.
Not at all, huh?
No, it was very, very, very easy, very simple, and it was very natural.
So in other words, if you were to give any words of advice to any aspiring disc jockeys or ladies out there that maybe want to promote and start doing things in the polka field, it's very simple to do.
All I could say to them is you've got to love it. If you don't, forget it.
Okay. let's talk about the associations that you're involved with. You are what are you in the spa, a secretary?
The recording secretary.
Recording secretary.
Yes. Yeah.
You've been in that position for a number of years, have you not?
Since the organization was started 7 years ago. Mm-hmm. I've been secretary right from the very start.
And now you're a director with the United Polka Association.
Yes.
In their new Niles chapter.
That's right.
Do you think that ever someday down the road that we could all come together as one big organization or...
I sure hope so. That's one of the problems why the polka field is not progressing as rapidly as it should, because there isn't that unity that should be there.
Why is it?
I really don't know whether it's a matter of one organization trying to outdo the next one or just what the problem is, but it seems like everybody does their own thing instead of getting together and doing it together.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It should be like the Crusade of Mercy or
Salvation Army or American Red Cross.
Right, you know,
yeah.
Get it all together. There's strength in unity.
Right, exactly. And that possibly could, you know, advance us to the national recognition
that
we're looking
exactly
for.
Right. That's exactly right. And you know who I think would be a good one to get this together would be Eddie Blazontrik, because he is a very fair man.
Right.
And he's very unselfish. And I think that he would be able to maybe get the things going.
Well, you know, things like this have been tried, but you have these different personalities. You have Johnny Hisney, who started the United Polka Association for whatever reason, who started the International Polka Association. And then I understand in the interim that the United Polka Association was supposed to start the Senior Polka Association. It was supposed to be like an offshoot. And then Chet Galinsky started that up. So now, right there, you have let's, for a lack of a better person to use, you've got Leon Kazicki, maybe heading up the IPA.
Yeah,
you've got Johnny Hisney, and you've got Chet Galinsky. Now, those are three different personalities that you have to deal with.
Yes.
And everybody wants to do things their own way.
And the reason all these other two organizations got started was because both Chet Galinsky and Johnny Hisney were unhappy with the International. So mm-hmm. Johnny started the United.
Right.
Chet Galinsky was in the United.
Mm-hmm.
He was unhappy, so he dropped out and
right.
started the Senior.
Exactly.
Know. And now...
You know, we're all pulling from the same group, basically,
right.
the same group of
it's
people.
It's sad. It's really sad to see it going the way it is.
All right, Emily, we're going to continue with this conversation, but right now we have to break to hear from our sponsors. So we'll be back with more of Emily Richards here on Polka Video Spotlight.
I cried a tear.
She's won 4 Grammys.
I was confused.
15 gold albums.
You cleared my mind.
Anne Murray.
We'll be shadows in the moonlight.
Heartland Music presents Anne Murray in a 2-album collection of her biggest and best loved hits.
Could I have this dance for the rest of my life? Just another woman in love, a kid out of school.
Anne brings so much warmth and honesty to every song she sings.
And oh, I just fall in love again.
Murray songs you really love on two beautiful albums.
No, I don't think time is gonna heal this broken heart. And even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey.
This special Ann Murray collection is not in stores. Please stay tuned to order.
So high that I could almost see eternity. You needed me.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-441-3939. To save all COD charges and pay only $12.98 for records or cassettes, or $16.98 for CD, plus $3 shipping, use your credit card or send check or money order to Ann Murray, 5944 North Milwaukee Avenue, Chicago, Illinois. Remember, save COD charges by sending check or money order or use your credit card.
My parents had their mortgage there. They financed my college education. The name has changed, and they're better than ever.
They know my business, my competition. We want to keep growing, and they know how to make it happen.
They're right down the street. And they helped me save so that I could travel when I retired. Their ideas worked.
LaSalle Tallman, LaSalle National, and all the LaSalle banks together were stronger than ever and working for all of Chicago. If your bank's not working for you, call on LaSalle, the bank that works.
We're back, and we're joined with Emilie Richards this month on the Poker Video Spotlight. Emilie, what else would you like to accomplish in the poker field while you're still around here?
There's many things I'd like to accomplish, but of course my time is limited, and my strength is limited. But if I can do a real good job as a radio disc jockey...
Well, you do that already. You've been on for 5 years.
There's always room for improvement. There's always room for improvement. This is my idea. If I can be tops, I'll be happy.
How about an Antonina Blazonchik Award? Would that be something that you might be looking
for? Oh, well, now you've got to be in a poker field for 10 years to be eligible
you've
for that.
You've only got five more
I've
to go.
I've only got five more
right.
to go.
Right.
I hope so. I hope someday I'll realize that.
What, if there's one thing that you'd like to see done in the poker field, not by yourself, but by the poker field as a whole, to maybe better it and make it a nicer place to be involved in. What would that one thing be?
I would like to see another association formed, another polka association, and that would be the Junior Polka Association. Get all the young people involved in it. And in addition to the parents encouraging them, some of us that have been in it for a while should do everything in our power to encourage the young people. This is the coming generation, and we don't want the poker field to die with us when we're gone. We mm-hmm. want it to continue, we want it to progress, to get better, and be tops eventually, surpass all the others.
Do you think it's necessary that we start a separate organization, or can we maybe have an offshoot of some of the other organizations?
Well, they're going to be running into problems,
yeah,
you know.
That's
which
true.
Organization?
Yeah, right, exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
So, who knows? I think a separate one started individually, divorced from all the other three mm-hmm. by itself, with a different perspective on the polka field, on life in general, I think it would be far more successful.
I think you're right. That's an interesting outlook. We've... You know, I've been doing this type of show once a month for the past 4 years, and you're the first person that's mentioned that.
But you know what, Keith?
What?
You would be the one to do it.
Oh, I would. Would I?
You are the younger generation.
Well, all I need is a couple more hours and a couple more days in the week, Emilie. But no, that is a very good idea.
I think it's an interesting idea, and I think it should be developed further.
Well, real quick, before we say goodbye, we want to remind you viewers out there that we have a big special event coming up on Memorial Day, the 24th, or 27th, I should say, of May at Polonia. Now, you're going to be there because you were one of our contestants in
yes.
Name That Polka. It's an interesting and exciting event, and we'd like to give you all the information on that. It's coming up in a few weeks at Polonia.
After dating the guy forever, you think I could tell him anything.
Why is this so hard? I'm really scared.
It takes a lot of guts to tell someone he's too drunk to drive. But you can do it. Just say it. Because if you don't, there may be nothing left to say.
Kevin,
I'm going to drive.
Take the keys, call a cab, take a stand. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word.
Last year, thousands of innocent children were caught in the crossfire of violent crime. And it's not just the children who suffer. How much longer will you let this go on? Call this number now. We'll send you information on how you can protect your children from crime and drugs in your neighborhood. Together, we will take a bite out of crime.
What are you doing this weekend that's so important you can't take a little time to test your home for radon? After all, it is the second leading cause of lung cancer, and a radon test kit is inexpensive. You could pick one up on your way to get a few things for the yard.
Well, Emily, it's certainly been a pleasure to have you. Real quick, I want to ask you, if there's one person that you'd want to thank for getting you involved, or somebody that's done something special for you, or someone who's seen you through all thick and thin, who would that one person be?
You're not going to like this, Keith. Chet Galinsky.
Why would you say that?
Chet Galinsky gave me the opportunity to have the radio show on WPNA. Mm-hmm. And I'm grateful to him for that. We have our differences at times, but we work together, and in spite of our differences, we get a lot of things accomplished.
Well, that's good.
And he was the one that gave me my first opportunity to come back to radio after some 35 years. So I'm grateful to him for that.
Well, that's fine. I have no... We have differences, too. We just don't get along, that's all, at certain times. But he helped me along in the poker field, too, when I first started out. So, I don't have a problem with that. Well, Emily, I wish you nothing but the highest accolades. I hope you stay on for another 50 years and continue along in promoting the poker music as you do. And you really provide entertainment, not just for your age group, but I listen all the time, too.
Thank you very much.
Great to have somebody around that, you're a nice lady, you're friendly, you're always at all the affairs, and it's a pleasure to see you involved in the poker field.
Thank you.
We're going to wind up today with a video, and some people may not know what this lady looks like, because every week after you close your show, you play One Day at a Time by Regina Cuyaba.
Right.
Well, we've got that for you on video right now.
And it's funny. The name of the song is One Day at a Time, and yet many of our listeners call that song I'm Only a Woman.
Really?
They'll call me and they'll say, why don't you play I'm Only a Woman all the way through instead of just the beginning of it?
All right, Emily.
One Day at a Time.
One Day at a Time or Only a Woman. It's been a pleasure to have
you here. It's a real pleasure being here. Thank you for
having
again.
Me. Thanks again. We'll be back next month on Poker Video Spotlight. Good night, everybody.
I'm only human. I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way. One day at a time.
The preceding program was a production of ETC, Ethnic Television Chicago.